Can you hear me now? What's good, PowerDirector peeps? Today, I decided to give you all a little PowerDirector love by showing you how to normalize and adjust your audio levels using PowerDirector 18. If you're looking for ways to get your audio right using PowerDirector, I want you to put hashtag audio level in the comment section below. Here we are in PowerDirector 18. PowerDirector allows you to normalize audio and adjust audio levels on the same timeline track to ensure that your audience has the best viewing experience possible. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly normalize and adjust your audio levels. Let's get normal. As you can see on the timeline, there are three clips. Looking at the waveforms, you can tell that the audio clip, which is the clip in the middle, is louder than the two clips with the audio and video in them. So, let's normalize the clips to get them to the same volume level. The first thing that you can do is press F9 on your keyboard to open the audio mixing room, or you can go up to the audio mixing room icon and left click on it. Any track with audio in it will be enabled. You can change the decibel level for each clip, the gain for each track, normalize each track, and add fades to the start and the end of a clip. Tracks with no audio will be disabled and no changes can be made. Now, if I place my playhead over each clip, you can tell that there is a decibel level, and a decibel level is 0 dBs. So wherever I place my playhead right now, each clip should say 0 dB. This is the default for each clip, regardless of how many decibels it truly has. It's basically your starting point. So in order to go ahead and get the waveforms to be the same size and the audio to be the same level, you need to click on the normalize button. It does its super duper normalizing magic. And now, as you can see, the size of the waveform for each clip on this track is now the same, which means that the volume matches. Also, if you go ahead and place your playhead over each one of these clips again, you can see that the decibel levels have changed. This one's 0 still, but if we place it over the middle clip, you can see that it's been brought down to -15.9, and this clip stayed at 0. So basically, the normalization process went ahead and changed them from 0 to a new number based on what PowerDirector needed to do to normalize the audio clip on the track. Unfortunately, now the wave for the audio only clip went down to where the other waveforms are at. This might be lower than what you want it to be, so we need to fix that. But before we do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to PowerDirector University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. If you decide to subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. And don't forget to follow PDU Tutorials on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for even more PowerDirector love. Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial. To fix the volume, we need to adjust the gain for the entire track. Since everything is the same now, we should be good to adjust the gain on everything, and everything should go up to the same level. So what we'll do is we'll go to the gain slider, and we'll go ahead and move this up slowly. And as we do, we should see the waveforms for each one of the clips getting larger. Now, if you go too far over to the right, if you start to see yellow dots, go back over to the left until all the yellow dots are gone. There were no yellow dots here. The yellow dots basically means that you're clipping. We can play back each clip to see if the audio levels sound similar. If you're looking for ways to get your audio right using PowerDirector, I want you to put hashtag audio level. In the comment section below.
It look all beautiful.
And that's how you remove unwanted objects from your videos using PowerDirector 18. Everything sounds beautiful. And that is how you normalize and adjust your audio levels using PowerDirector 18. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 18 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software or purchase a 365 annual subscription, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.